More than 3 billion people in almost 70 countries and territories have been asked to stay at home. A quarter of the world's population is now living under some form of lockdown due to coronavirus.
A lockdown will be the biggest disruption to daily life many of us will ever experience.
Italy is on total lockdown.
If anybody wants an idea of what the future may hold, a worst case scenario, don't look any further than Italy.
The Spanish government looks set to impose a 15-day nationwide lockdown.
France is just hours away from a nationwide lockdown.
Colombia's president has ordered the country into lockdown.
A two-week lockdown in Bavaria.
Here in Istanbul, the city's really been shutting down.
Prime Minister Boris Johnson put the UK on lockdown today.
It's vital to slow the spread of the disease.
New Zealand has just entered an unprecedented lockdown.
We have always said we would act early, decisively, and go hard.
India has become the latest and largest country to introduce a nationwide lockdown in the fight against the coronavirus. Its population of 1.3 billion has been told to stay at home.
Those with homes can stay home, but we are seeing homeless shelters at the moment inundated.
Human rights groups say India's lockdown has disproportionately affected migrant and daily wage workers.
More than 56 million South Africans dealing with a new reality, the challenge of a three-week lockdown to combat the coronavirus.
During the lockdown, the wealthy will retreat to their luxury homes while the poor remain crammed in townships like this one.
We're talking about the mass quarantine. Could something like that happen here in the U.S.?
I think it's definitely possible.
California streets empty as nearly 40 million people in that state are sequestered, closely followed by a similar order in New York. But a nationwide lockdown is not being considered.
Right now we're implementing restrictions on a statewide basis.
China is set to lift lockdown measures on Wuhan in just over 2 weeks.
The date is April 8th. This means people will now be allowed to leave the city, leave Hubei province, leave the original epicenter of this outbreak.